First things first, this is a video about Crossrail. Some are calling it the Elizabeth Line. I'm still maintaining that Crossrail is the mode and Elizabeth Line is the name of the line on that mode. We're not here to have that argument though. An argument that we are here to have though is why Crossrail is not a tube line. So there's been a couple of comments on YouTube. Some people have said it to me in person about the fact that Crossrail, Elizabeth Line, will be seen as just another tube line and it should be an underground line. And my fear about calling it something line was that the minute you call it something line and stick it on the tube map, people view it as another tube line. People already kind of do it. I was on the overground the other day, London Overground, coming down through New Cross, and a friend is on his phone speaking to his friend and he's like, yeah man, I'm on the tube. And his friend has obviously said which line, and he just said the orange one. So to some people, even the overground is the tube, is the underground, which it isn't. It's just a distinct mode. I'm here to give you reasons why Crossrail, Elizabeth Line, is not the underground. Here we go. They're big trains. They share many characteristics with mainline national rail trains. Firstly, they're powered by overhead. There's no third or fourth rail. All the underground have got the third and fourth rails. DC traction picks it up, puts it into the national rail train category. It is not an underground train. Other things that it shares, except, I know otherwise I should say it because I get comments, except for the Thameslink core where the doors automatically open themselves, you have to press the button on Crossrail trains for the doors to open. Oh, actually outside of London, is it also Merseyrail? I think so, where the doors open automatically. As a rule though, I think, like, you know, 90% plus of the cases on a national rail train, you have to manually open the doors yourself. The point is, on all underground trains, the doors automatically open at every stop. On Crossrail, Elizabeth Line trains, doesn't do that. You have to press the button to open the door. You have to press the button with that very loud noise as well to quite clearly indicate that you're at a station and the doors are now openable. This, to me, straight away makes it stand out as not a tube train and therefore not an underground train. If all the stations were happening, say, next year in 2019, there'd be some new stations. Our magic figure of 2563 would have increased. 2564 would be Kenilworth. 2565 would be Maggle, not Maghull. Maggle North on Merseyside, as we just mentioned. But there are five new stations in the centre of London that are currently tube stations that are having Crossrail added to them. And those stations will get added to the ORR, the Office of Rail and Road, statistics list. No other underground station has that, apart from the Metropolitan Line. We'll get to that in a second. But the fact that the ORR are adding now, I think it's five. I think Bond Street should be National Rail Station 2566. Tottenham Court Road, currently just a tube station, now having Crossrail added to it, will be 2567. Canary Wharf, separate station from DLR and Jubilee, will be 2568. Canada Water 2569, and Woolwich will be Britain's 2570th National Rail Station. They will be statistically counted as National Rail Stations because they're not part of the underground. Just a quick one, yeah, if you don't know what TOP stands for, sorry, I had to Google it as well, Total Operations Processing System. There is a link in the description. It's just the classification system by which trains are listed in this country. So when we talk about the Crossrail purple trains, purple, yay, being class 3, 4, 5, that is its TOPS number. Underground trains do not have TOPS numbers. They're not in that classification system. Why? Because Crossrail trains are not underground trains. It is not an underground line. I've made this one before on the Don't Call Crossrail the Elizabeth Line video. Got to be careful with this, there is a caveat. Because Crossrail will serve other national rail stations outside of London. Tube trains don't go to Reading or Maidenhead, do they? Now, I know what you're saying. You're saying, ah, oh, but Geoff, Metropolitan Line. Yeah, good point. And it holds up, almost, right until the fact that actually National Rail doesn't go to Croxley or Watford or Chesham. Those are exclusively tube stations out there. If the Metropolitan Line only served National Railway stations outside of London, you could argue that that section of the tube was National Rail, but it's not. But Crossrail All the stations it serves are classified as national rail stations, again, because it's not an underground line. And the fifth reason, and if you haven't been convinced so far, then this is the main one, this is the main decider. The main reason why Crossrail is not an underground line is because TfL themselves say so. Again, link in the description, you can download the Elizabeth Line design idiom. Interestingly, because I bang on about Elizabeth Line being the name of the line and Crossrail should be the mode, TfL in this document lists all their modes, like trams, and river, and buses, and underground as one, and what do you know, Crossrail, Elizabeth Line, there it is, as a separate mode to the underground. They don't consider it the same thing. TfL themselves identify it as being two different modes, because it is not an underground line. Oh, and there's one little final caveat, maybe this is number six, to tag on the end. It's to do with the tube map. This is the new tube map. I was chatting to somebody yesterday, I was out riding TfL Rail, what will become Crossrail, out of Paddington to Hayes, down to Heathrow, and they've added this section there, onto the tube map. And TfL Rail, at the moment, the section that is Liverpool Street out to Shenfield and now Paddington to Hayes and Harlington and Heathrow, aren't shown on the map as solid lines, yeah? They're like, they're two parallel lines. All the other lines on the map that are tube lines are solid in colour. Think of the central line, solid red. Think of the northern line, solid black. Think of the Piccadilly line, solid dark blue. Overground, two lines, orange. DLR, two lines in the tiki, whatever colour it is. That'll be the ultimate thing. When Crossrail is put on the map in December of this year, in December of 2018, it's not a solid line, it's not a tube line. And I'm telling you now, it won't be a solid line. And that is why Crossrail is not a tube line. But I'm sure you're going to want to discuss it in the comments below.